what is the shape of the earth? The shape of the earth appears to be round. Okay, it appears to be round. However, it is not perfectly round. It is somewhat like an orange in shape. Can you see the shape of an orange? Slightly bent, that is slightly flattened at the top and at the bottom. This shape is called a sphere. Okay, it's a sphere shape. So the earth is round in shape, but it is not completely round. It is flattened on the top, that is, this is the north and this is the south. So the earth is flattened on the north surface and the south. So the shape of the earth is not round, it is in the shape of a sphere. Yes, you can see here, if the earth shape is compared to an orange, it is flat on both the sides, that is on the north and in the southern part. Okay. Movements of the earth. The earth shows two kinds of movements. How many kinds of movement does earth show? It shows two kinds of movements. One is rotation and the other one is revolution. So what are the two kinds of movements? Rotation and revolution. So the first thing is rotation. Rotation of the earth. The spinning movement of the earth on its own axis is called rotation of the earth. Earth rotates from west to east. Can you see this? The spinning movement of the earth is called as rotation. Okay, the spinning movement of the earth is called as rotation. And the earth rotates from west to east. Okay, from west to east, it goes on rotating. Axis is the imaginary line passing through the center of the earth. This is called as an axis. It is an imaginary line. Actually, axis is not present. Okay, it is just imagined by the scientist for us to explain. Can you see here? This is called as the axis, the center line. The axis of the earth is tilted at a certain angle. Can you see? The earth is not spinning straight. It is bent on one side. Sometimes towards the north it is bent and sometimes it is bent towards the south. Okay. Sometimes, can you see this axis? It is bent towards the north. Yes. Then sometimes it is bent towards the south. Rotation of the earth on its axis also causes day and night. When the earth rotates, different parts of its face, different parts of it face the sun at different times. The part of the earth that faces the sun has day, and the part of the earth that is away from the sun has night. Can you see here? When the earth is rotating, what happens? There are countries all over the earth. So the part of the earth which is facing the sun will have day. And now the other side of the earth is having night because it is not facing the sun. So it takes 24 hours to do one rotation of the earth. The earth completes one rotation in 24 hours. It rotates on its axis in west-east direction. That is why the sun seems to rise in the east and set in the west. Because the earth is rotating from west to east, so morning when we see, it seems like the sun rises from the east and sets in the west. Now next is revolution of the earth. The revolution of the earth. The movement of the earth around the sun is called revolution. So can you see here? Rotation of the earth causes day and night, whereas revolution of the earth causes season. First understand what is revolution. Revolution means the earth spins and rotates and goes around the sun one time to complete its rotation. Let us keep this as a starting point here. Okay. Now the earth is rotating and revolving around the sun. So when it is starting from one side, it goes on revolving around the sun and completes one circle. Complete still here. That means it is completed one revolution. So to go around the sun one time, the earth needs 365 days and 6 hours. Okay, that is quarter day. 365 days and quarter day to complete one circle around the sun. Okay, so this is called as revolution, and revolution causes seasons. Okay, remember, rotation of the earth causes day and night, revolution of the earth causes seasons. So today you have studied about the planet Earth, its rotation and revolution, the shape of the earth, and also the layers of the earth. Wasn't it an interesting topic? Yes. So we have completed the lesson today. So complete exercise A, exercise B in your textbook, and complete exercise C in your classroom. Thank you.